I am thrilled you are with us today on the David Pakman Show, and I want to talk about a story that is taking some of my, you know, this thing happens on the show where I kind of propose different ideas for technologies or different things, and usually Lewis says they're incredibly unlikely or it'll never happen or it's stupid or we're not going to see it. Well, I've had the theoretical discussion on the show many, many times, and I think we did it once maybe as like a morality with Motomedy or as an audience question of, would a vegetarian be okay eating meat that was indistinguishable, for example, let's say beef. It was indistinguishable from meat taken from a living cow, except it was literally grown molecule by molecule, atom by atom in a lab. It has the same nutritional value. It is indistinguishable from actual real cow meat, except it never came from a living animal. Ethically speaking, would a vegetarian who doesn't eat animals be okay eating that? There were varying discussions about it, but one of the things that came out of it was we're probably kind of far from this type of thing. Not so. A hamburger that looks like one you would get at any fast food restaurant comes with the price of $330,000, and the reason why is it's not made of natural meat. Volunteers are going to be tasting it in front of VIPs and TV cameras, and they're going to be eating the first publicly available burger that comes from a lab instead of a dead animal. And the way this works is that researchers are going to mix lab-grown beef muscle cells with salt, egg powder, and breadcrumbs. Then they're going to add beet juice and saffron to give it a more natural color. It is a bloodless burger after all, so it wouldn't have that color. It's going to be fried up in a pan. It's going to be seasoned with a little salt and pepper. And with any luck, it should taste basically like typical ground beef. What do you think about this? What do you think? This is really getting close now. And we have study after study. The real world implications, aside from just being interesting for vegetarians, is that many studies show that the way farming is done right now will be unsustainable by 2050. It'll happen that way because of the rising population combined with growing hunger for meat in a lot of countries like China and Brazil. So if you could grow meat in this way, not only could it be fun for vegetarians because they could, I guess, have meat maybe without actually having dead animals, but there's a real possibility of affecting food shortages and food supply problems in this country. Now, PETA likes this. PETA is actually sponsoring $1 million prize for the first venture to commercialize the production of lab-grown chicken meat. This can't possibly be worse than a McDonald's burger in the U.S., right? I mean, this. What do we even call it? An in-vitro burger, I guess, for lack of a better term. I think that this is very, very interesting. You know, in science fiction, for a long time, there's been the idea that in the future, you basically just have a matter machine that can take source elements for things that exist on Earth and combine them in such a way that it, you know, a burger comes out or a chicken breast or whatever the case may be. It is indistinguishable from the original chicken breast that really came from live chickens, but it doesn't. And it's basically just created from the ground up, almost like a 3D printer. It's layer by layer just created. This is step one to that. And I think it is absolutely fascinating. So now that this is becoming more of a real thing, I still am interested in the vegetarian question. I know a lot of vegetarians and I'm interested in this. This is created, like I said, from lab-grown beef muscle cells, salt, egg powder, breadcrumbs, beet juice, and saffron. Obviously, egg powder means that if you're vegan, you wouldn't have this. But for vegetarians, would you try this? What do you think? Send me your thoughts. Very interesting stuff.